Welcome to Grace for Today. Blessings, everybody. God bless you. May the hand of the Lord be upon you. May his face shine upon you. We are grateful for all of the Lord is doing and his faithfulness to each and every one of us. We're going to give you a few moments to come on. I'm a little warm, of course, because it's, I know we have air, but mine's not on real high, but blessings to everybody. God bless you. We're going to give you just a little bit. And good morning. Hey, y'all. Okay. For some reason, this is not working like it did yesterday. Okay. Good morning. Hey, everybody. Can y'all hear me? Y'all okay? You should, I think. I didn't change any settings. Okay. There. All right. So, today is Day 84, talking about destiny destroyers. And we've been talking about Joseph. And I tell you, it's like when you get a new car, you get to hear everybody talk about the same thing. So I was listening to Pastor Hannah this morning talking about from yesterday's Bible study. And he was talking about Joseph as well. Isn't that amazing? You get to hear. Good morning, everybody. You get to hear somebody else sharing the same word. But I am just grateful that God is speaking. God is talking to us. Are you hearing him? Do you hear him? Are we listening to him when he's talking to us? And I believe the Lord is speaking loud and clear to each and every one of us. And I hope that the word of God is penetrating our hearts and that we're hearing him talk to us about our own Joseph experience. That sounds good. Our own Joseph experience. So let's get started. Good morning, everybody. So let's pick up. I think we're looking at verse 6, I think is where we are. I want to start back right there where Joseph begins talking to his brothers and sharing with them, some truths that he has learned and gleaned. Sometimes God has to delay our process. Good morning. Hey, y'all. Delay our process because we don't get what we need to begin with. But God wants to move us forward. God wants to help us. He wants to give us what we need so that we can be strong in him and accomplish the things we should. Sometimes we don't even know what God's trying to do. We have our own opinions. We have, good morning, absolutely, Pastor Brent. We sometimes have our own ideas about what God is doing, but we don't always know. We have our own perspective. We know what other people have said to us, but we need to understand that God's way is always the best way. And we only know in part. That's what the scripture says. We know in part. We prophesy in part. We see in part. We don't know everything, but we see what we see, and we only can see that. That's it. We don't know everything else, but we can trust the God who sees and knows. I can trust him, and so can you. He remains faithful. That's what his word says. He remains faithful, and God is faithful to you. He is faithful to me, too. So let's look into the word of the Lord. I know that we're talking about Joseph revealing himself to his brothers. And I want to pick up right there because that is where we want to go from that point. And he says, for these 2 years, the famine hath been in the land, and yet there are 5 years in which there shall neither be hearing nor harvest. But I think the other version translation we read said planting nor harvest. And God sent me before you. So he understood. He understood what had happened. He understood why he went the way he went. He understood the road that he took. Beloved, there's an old song that says, we'll understand it better by and by. Exactly, Annie Ingram. The king has need of me. The king has need of me. He has need of me. He has need of you too, beloved. And the song, right, says, by and by, we'll understand it better by and by. You don't understand everything right now. That's why it's called faith, because you don't see it. You don't even understand it. That's why we trust him for our next. We trust him for our processes. He says, and God sent me before you to preserve you a posterity in the earth. and to save your lives by a great deliverance. He understood, verse 8, so now it was not you that sent me here. Who put him in the pit? It may have been them physically, but God orchestrated their lives. Orchestrated Joseph's life. But he said, it was not you that sent me hither, but God. You may have been the hands that God used, but it wasn't for my demise as you thought it was. Your hatred may have been the catalyst that God used, but your hatred put me in a better place. It didn't look better at the time, but it was better because of where I am now. Beloved, you got to trust God for the process. Don't look at just this moment. That's it, Elder Ingram. Don't worry about it. Don't fear. Don't be anxious. Don't fret. Put on the garment of praise and let God work in you his will. Work in you his will. I know we find it hard to believe that any good can come out of the awful things that transpire in our lives. And yes, there are awful things that happen in our lives. Yes, there are. There are things that devastate our hearts. There are things that hurt us. Yes, there are. But beloved, when we trust God, we don't have to understand it all. We need to trust him. We need to believe. That's the scripture, Sister Janet. Be anxious for nothing, but in everything, with prayer and thanksgiving. We need to learn how, in the midst of it, be like Job, though you slay me, though we know, because we know the story, it wasn't God slaying him. It was God's testimony about Job. Can God testify about you and you not say God is unfaithful? Can God testify about you and you go through your trial and God still say you gonna come out victorious? Can God testify about you and you lose everything and you still count God faithful? Let's read on. He says, so now was not you that sent me hither, but God, and he hath made me a father to Pharaoh and lord of all his house. Joseph understood. Hey, Lori. Okay, calm down. God, Joseph understood who he was. How long did it take him? I don't know, but some years. We think somehow we're supposed to get it overnight. You're not going to be no overnight wonder, beloved. You got to go through the process too. And the longer you take to understand, there's a song. It's an old song. I don't know who sings it. Somebody will know. It says, God is preparing. God is preparing me. Let him prepare you. Let him prepare you. Joseph says in verse 9, haste ye, go up to my father and say unto him, thus saith thy son Joseph. Now he's saying, go back and tell my daddy. Your son Joseph, God has made me Lord of all Egypt. Come on down unto me. Don't tarry. Don't wait. Hurry up. Verse 10, and thou shalt dwell in the land of Goshen. Joseph could give this place to his daddy, to his family, to all their people because he was the one in charge. When you have the authority, God will place you in authority not to cause harm to people that you love, but to cause them to receive what they couldn't have received before. They would have not had a place called Goshen had it not been for Joseph going ahead of them preparing that place. Here, get this. He says, and thou shalt be near unto me, you and your children's children and thy flocks. He said, I got enough room for everybody. He says, for your flock, for your herd and all that you have. And there will I nourish you. Joseph says, I'm going to take care of you. I'm going to take care of you. I'm going to provide for you. For yet there are 5 years of famine, lest thou and thy household and all that thou hast come to poverty. He says, I'm here to be what you need. Glory to our great God. I'm here to be your provider. God put me here to make sure that what you need is provided. Woo, bless God, hallelujah. He says to him, and ye shall tell, and you, he says, behold, your eyes see, and the eyes of my brother Benjamin, that it is my mouth that speaketh unto you. The other translation that I read to you the other day, let me see if I can find it real quick. That's verse 12. I'm going to read that to you. 45 verse 12. He says, and behold, your eyes see, and the eyes of my brother Benjamin, that it is my mouth that speaketh unto you. He says, listen, it's me. It's your brother Joseph. And ye shall tell, let me read to you from the New Living, the Christian Standard Bible. He says, look, your eyes and the eyes of my brother Benjamin can see that I'm the one speaking to you. They were like, I can't believe. They were still in dismay that this person we thought we destroyed, we killed, we annihilated, we hated. He said, look, I'm the one speaking to you. You remember, I told you, God said, I'm going to make room for you. Here you see God making room for them. They hated Joseph, but God was using Joseph to make room for them. My time is almost gone. Here, he says, look, your eyes. He says, look at me. Your eyes and the eyes of my brother Benjamin can see that I'm the one speaking to you. Tell my father about all my glory in Egypt. And about all you have seen, and bring my father here quickly. Joseph wasn't trying to hide. He said, listen, I want my daddy to see. I want my dad. There's a time for us to remind each other. Look what God has done. See, we think it's boasting and bragging. I tell you what, we need to stop thinking that people are arrogant. Now, sometimes they may be, but we need to be okay with folks saying, look what God has done for me. Look what he's done. Don't get jealous. Don't say, well, I wish it was me. Be glad. Look what God has done. Go get my daddy and bring him quickly. Tell them about all the glory you've seen God do for me right here in Egypt. Then Joseph threw his arms, verse 14, threw his arms around his brother Benjamin and wept. And Benjamin wept on his shoulder. Joseph kissed each of his brothers as he wept. And afterward, his brothers talked with him. You're talking about forgiveness. Forgiveness? Real forgiveness? Weeping and crying? Ah, that's it. Love overruled. That's it, Sister Cassie. Love covers. Love really does cover. Sometimes we're just talking about feelings. But love, real love, really does cover. Look, it goes beyond that. Verse 16, that's where I'm going to stop. Y'all hold on for another minute or two. When the news reached Pharaoh's palace, Joseph's brothers have come. Pharaoh and his servants were pleased. Joseph had blessed Pharaoh. They were pleased that Joseph, someone whose Pharaoh had no idea about who Joseph was. Remember, Joseph came out of prison. All Pharaoh knew was this was somebody who was in prison who could interpret dreams that God had used. That's all they knew. Who, at the recommendation of Pharaoh, of Potiphar, came. His gift worked. His gift of administration, his gifting worked. And you have this man who nobody knew anything about but his brothers. So they welcomed his family. They were pleased that now Joseph had family. They were pleased. Listen, your story ain't over. I gotta go. My time is gone. Your story isn't over. They were pleased that Joseph, and it didn't stop there. Joseph was going to put his family in Goshen. Pharaoh had more in store. We'll pick that up Monday. All right, my time is gone. Let's pray. Father, we thank you so much for what you've done and for what you're doing in us. Thank you so much for your hand being upon us for good. You've got good stuff in store for us. Thank you that your thoughts concerning us are good and not able to give us hope and expected. And thank you, Lord, for what you've done and for what you're doing in us. We honor you and we bless you even now. You're a mighty good Father. open our hearts to expect good, to look for good, and to be okay with good chasing us down and overtaking us, our sisters, and our brothers. Remind us that your thoughts about us are good. In Jesus' name, cover our children. Goodness and mercy are following us all the days of our lives. And we'll bless you and we'll give you glory. Give us testimonies about your goodness, because you did it, and you did it for us. You did it for us, and we'll thank you for it. We receive it done in the mighty name of Jesus. So it is. Amen. All right, everybody. God bless everybody. I tell you what, the Lord has been good to me. I just want to tell you, he's been good to me. What? Who put that in there? Victoria Johnson. My story ain't over either, honey. Sure ain't. Good morning, Trail. Blessings, Cut, my nephew. My story, I love you bunches. My story ain't over, because God's got good stuff in store for me. I'm going to trust him for my next. All right, y'all pray for it. Got traveling tomorrow, coming back to the States. But listen, y'all pray for us. I believe God to do more. Thank you for sharing. Don't forget to share. Type in, catch the replay. Hashtag graced for today. I appreciate all of you. Thank you all for bearing with us for our little issue earlier this week. God bless you. And don't forget to expect God to move for you. Expect him to move. Expect doors to open. Expect favor. I know I didn't do any pictures of Puerto Rico, and I should, but I could. I should. Y'all pray for me. All right. I'll try. See y'all. Hey, Glenda. All right. Blessings. I got to go. Listen, y'all have a good weekend. And we hope to see you all Monday morning at 7:15 a.m. Central Time. We'll upload this to YouTube in about an hour or so. Thank you, Sister Hope. I love you bunches. And we'll see you all Monday morning, Lord willing. We'll pick this up. And until then, remember this. Time spent in the Word of God is never wasted. And you have been graced for today. Have a great day, everybody. Have a good weekend. Don't forget to follow this page as well as our YouTube channel. Until then, God bless you all. Peace.